Hi, Art here, and welcome back to Stem Cell Talks. Today we want to talk about the wisdom of banking your stem cells. Tens of millions of families choose to bank their stem cells to protect their family's future health. They do this primarily through cord blood banking and the banking of stem cells from teeth. So this begs the question, why? Why do millions of families choose to provide what in essence is biological insurance to themselves and their families by banking their stem cells? Today we're going to attempt to answer this question. The wisdom of banking stem cells is based on two pillars of logic: the unique properties of stem cells and the emerging field of regenerative medicine. Now, stem cells are the only cells that have the ability to regenerate. They are the body's natural repair and maintenance mechanism. You are constantly replacing the cells in your body. For example, you replace 30 to 40,000 skin cells every day. That's because underneath the skin that you see are skin stem cells pushing out new skin all day long. The fact is, over the course of 7 to 10 years, you replace every cell in your body. And some stem cells have a unique characteristic known as plasticity, which means they can be differentiated into different types of tissue. So for instance, the stem cells from teeth can be differentiated into bone, skin, cartilage, pancreatic beta cells that are insulin producing, cardiomyocytes, neurons, muscle, which means they can be applied to a broad range of therapies to treat a wide variety of disease, trauma, and injury, which makes them particularly valuable. The other pillar of logic behind banking your stem cells? The emerging field of regenerative medicine, which is based on the unique properties of stem cells to, as the name implies, regenerate. Regenerative treatments are designed to maintain your health by utilizing the body's natural repair and maintenance mechanisms. They are designed to treat the root cause of the issue, not just the symptoms. Hence, they have the potential to cure disease and reverse trauma. So, just as anesthesia revolutionized medicine in the 19th century, and antibiotics revolutionized medicine in the 20th century, regenerative medicine will revolutionize medicine in the 21st century. And families choosing to bank their stem cells recognize this as an emerging trend. Another reason to bank your stem cells is they age along with the individual. We have fewer stem cells as we age, and they are less active. So for example, when an infant is first born, one out of every 10,000 cells is a stem cell. Now this makes a lot of sense. That infant is going to be growing very rapidly. They're going to need more bone, more skin, more cartilage, more neurons. So you need a lot of stem cells, and they have to be very active to fuel this growth. By the time you're a teenager, one out of every 100,000 cells is a stem cell. Now this makes a lot of sense as well, because as you reach the apex of your growth curve, which typically happens in your late teens or early 20s, you stop growing, so your stem cells are no longer fueling growth, and what they're doing is they go into maintenance mode. By the time you're 30, one out of every 300,000 cells is a stem cell. Now, many of you may remember the old saying, over the hill at 30. Now, I know 40 is the new 30. There's actually a biological reason for that. And that's because at around the age of 30, we start to lose more cells than we can replace. So we actually start to degrade. Now, that degradation is very gradual at first, but as we age, that degradation does begin to accelerate. By the time we're 50, one out of every 500,000 cells is a stem cell. By the time we're 70, one out of every million cells is a stem cell. So as you can see, as we age, we have fewer and fewer stem cells, and they're asked to do more, which they can't, which is why we age. So you want to save your stem cells when they're plentiful and active. Another reason to bank your stem cells? Cryopreservation. Cryopreservation is designed to stop all cellular metabolism. So let's say you're 18 and you're getting your wisdom teeth taken out and you decide to bank your stem cells. When those stem cells are cryopreserved, they're 18 years old. Let's fast forward 30 years, and you need a stem cell treatment. When you take those stem cells out of cryopreservation, they're still 18 years old. You may be 48, but your stem cells are 18, so you'll have these young, active stem cells to use for the regenerative treatment. Another reason to bank your stem cells? The best stem cells are your own. You don't have to worry about finding a donor, you don't have to worry about rejection, and you don't need to worry about taking immunosuppression drugs if you get donated cells. Another reason why families are choosing to bank their stem cells is increasing lifespans. Over the last century, we've seen a rapid increase in lifespans. But if you recall, as we age, we degrade. So the challenge is to stay healthy as our lifespans increase, what we like to refer to as health spans. And this is going to be accomplished with regenerative therapies utilizing stem cells. And keep in mind, kids today are going to live to be well over 100 years old. And in order to maintain their health during these longer lifespans, they're going to need their stem cells. So the wisdom of banking your stem cells is predicated on unique properties of stem cells, the fact that younger stem cells are more plentiful and more active, the emerging field of regenerative medicine, which utilizes the body's own natural repair and maintenance systems, and health spans, staying healthy while living longer. We want to thank you for joining us at Stem Cell Talks. We hope you found this information useful. We want to encourage you to visit our YouTube channel where we have lots of other informational videos. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you again soon.